गुड मॉर्निंग चैतन्या। We should start. Okay, let's get start. Yesterday we have just gone through the internal structure of all the three armed forces. So very first we have gone through. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So very first we have gone through internal structure of army, right from command to a smallest part called section. So that is what we can just recap. So so you have a largest part which can be termed as commands, and altogether there are seven different commands, right from in fact which are being divided into operational commands and training command. So you will be having the further bifurcation of these larger groups, right from commands into corps, into division, into brigades, into battalions, into companies, into battery, into platoons, into sections. So ultimately section would be the smallest outfit of Indian Army, whereas command would be the largest outfit of the Indian Army. So Indian Army is made by altogether seven different commands. Further, as like that, if you look, then you will find that some corps are forming commands, some divisions are forming corps, some brigades are forming divisions, some battalions are forming brigades, some companies are forming battalion. There would be aerial support to each of these battalion, that would be called as battery. Some platoons are forming companies, and obviously the section are forming the platoon. So whatever, if you have seen the contingent, which are basically called the companies, in fact, these are called the platoons, or platoons at the Republic Day or the Independence Day parade. Those who had been in NCC, they might be knowing about this one. So contingent is marching. Fine. So this point needs to be understood. I don't know. I have a problem with the chat box. Even today also, I'm not able to see the chat box. Many a times I clicked on it, but no, whatever the messages are in the chat box, I'm not able to read them. So this is what you have considered, right? So two or more corps, right? So we'll be forming a command. Altogether, we do have 14 different corps, and each of these corps is commanded by a lieutenant. Commanded by a rank of lieutenant general, whereas each of these command is being commanded by lieutenant general, which is senior most, right, which also, who is also called as army commander. Then division is usually it consists 3 to 4 brigades and forms a division, and each of these division is being headed by Major General, and you do have here around 40 divisions, including army infantry divisions, mountain divisions, armored divisions, artillery divisions, likewise. Further, around 3,000 combat troops will be forming the brigade, which is being commanded by a brigadier. Here you do have 5 independent armored brigades, 15 independent artillery brigades, 7 independent infantry brigades, 1 independent parachute brigade, 3 independent air defense brigades, 2 independent air defense groups, and 4 independent engineer brigades. Later on, you will come across battalion. So usually it is composed of 4 companies. So 4 companies will be forming the battalion, and battalion is being commanded by the colonel. So each of these battalion is having a Ghatak platoon, which is nothing but the commando section of that particular battalion. Later on, you will further go down. That will be the company. So company is composed of 3 platoons, which are being commanded by major or lieutenant colonel. And as I said, later on, you can come across battery, which usually comprises 3 or 4 sections in artillery and air defense units. So this is what the mixture, right? It is not for purely from army. So whenever, in fact, they are also belonging to army, but with the help of aerial gadgets or aerial equipments. That is what a slight difference between these and this one. Then platoon, which is composed of 3 sections, which is being commanded by a junior commissioned officer. And the last one is this section, which is called the smallest military outfit, in which you will be having a strength of 10 plus 1. Usually they are called 10, but the truth is that 10 plus 1. So one rifleman is always there. In fact, it is the mandatory. And it is being commanded by Havaldar. So senior most rank of non-commissioned officers. So altogether, these different things you have considered as far as army is concerned. Likewise, further you have considered the same kind of things which are in the Indian Air Force. So if you look into here, you will come across commands which are further being divided into wings, stations, squadrons and units, flights, sections, and there are three supporting branches called as flying branch related to flying, technical branch related to engineering, and ground branch, which is containing six different sections, right from logistics, administration, accounts, medical and dental, meteorological, right? Likewise, so all these six different sections are there in the ground command, ground branch. So as far as wing is concerned, which is nothing but the intermediate between command and squadron, usually two or three wings. Wing will consist usually two or three squadrons and helicopter units along with the forward base support units. So usually the forward base support units are not hosting any kind of squadrons or helicopter, but they can act as a transit air base for routine operations. But during wartime, they will be becoming fully full-fledged air bases. So altogether, 47 wings and 19 FPSUs are making Indian Air Force. So wings are typically commanded by Air Promoter. So you might be now remembering very simply the equivalent or Air Commodore in Indian Army is the Brigadier, right? So, and then squadrons are assigned to the stations. Now, within each operational command, there are anywhere from 9 to 16 stations or the bases are there. So what a command is consisting of, and which is always being, station is always being commanded by group captain. So a station typically has one wing and one or two squadrons assigned to it. Fine. So that is what you do consider. Later on, you will come to know the squadrons. And as I said, as like in Indian Army, battalion will be the first field formation. Likewise here, the squadron. So equivalently, you can keep them as an important factors. So through that point of view, here you do have the squadrons. So subunit of an air force, which is the okay. So the yes. So the squadrons are the subunits, which are the field units and formations attached to a static location. So squadron or unit is a subunit of an Air Force station, which will be always carrying out a primary task of Indian Air Force. So a fighter squadron usually consists of 18 aircrafts, and the squadron is being commanded by a wing commander. Fine. So you will be considering this point. And this is what one of the points or the glimpses you have considered as far as squadrons and units is concerned. Flights are subdivisions of squadrons, which are being commanded by a squadron leader. and each flight is consisting two sections. So again, you will be coming across the smallest unit of the Indian Air Force, that is sections. So led by a section is always led by a flight lieutenant, and each section consists of three aircrafts. So within the formation structure of Indian Air Force, it is having three service branches for its day-to-day operations. As I said, flying branch, then the ground branch and engineering branch. Right. No doubt further, they are assigned with their roles or duties. And the last one that we can consider is the commands in the Indian Navy. So basically, Eastern Naval Command and Western Naval Command, which are being acted as the operational commands, and one more is there, it's called Southern Naval Command at Kochi. So each of these commands in Navy are being commanded by Vice Admiral, and each of these operational commands are having a fleet, and that fleet is being commanded by Rear Admiral. So further, if you have in these fleets, so ships are being commanded by the let's say officer of the rank, right? After the Rear Admiral, after Vice Admiral, that is by the Rear Admiral. Apart from this, here you do consider additional command, which is being situated at Andaman Nicobar, particularly at its capital called Port Blair, and it is being jointly, or you can simply call it as a tri-service. No doubt, Indian Coast Guard is also supporting this particular operations of this particular command, along with Indian Navy, Indian Army, and Indian Air Force. Right. So that is what you do consider. Fine. So these were the different things which we have considered as far as commands are concerned, or the small parts are concerned. Fine. Now, okay, Ayush is asking why second lieutenant and regimental something Havaldar major no longer the ranks. Yes, it is true that nowadays these are not being used. Right? So directly you will be having a second lieutenant. The reason behind these is that unnecessary at some of the places it was making the complex, it was creating the complex situations. So to bring the easiness and also to honor the appropriate honor, to offer the appropriate honor, these particular ranks have been abolished. Right? So that though you are a second lieutenant, still you were called as the lieutenant. And then it was decided, in fact, it was thought. See, there are some of the recommendations always of after the particular period. Right? So purchasing Rafael is not a simple thing. That in fact, there had been committees which have been studied this particular thing, asked many officials in Indian Air Force, also some experts, then talked with the manufacturers, and then they prepared a kind of report and submitted to the government, in fact, to the defense ministry. And then defense ministry decides whether it should be accepted or not. So again, in one of the such kinds of what you can consider a committee's report, or the suggestion was that these ranks should be abolished to bring the easiness and also to honor the appropriate, to offer the appropriate honor to these people. And that is the reason why you can consider. Oh, one more thing, keep in mind, the continuous improvement is the rule by nature, right? So by the principle of nature, you can always have certain kinds of changes. So that is what the same thing is being applied here as well. Fine. So you will have the no longer existence of these ranks. Fine. Okay. Let's go to another point. And that is nothing but the gallantry awards. Fine. So now if you consider the gallantry awards, so you will have different medals in this category. So if you if you try to know what exactly this is and for what this is being offered. Fine. So awards, or you can call them as decorations, so of Indian Armed Forces, which are considered as the gallantry awards. So Indian Armed Forces are eligible for a myriad of military decorations. So these decorations are awarded for extraordinary bravery and courage shown by an individual, as well as distinguished services during times of war and even in the peace time as well. So keeping peace time also requires a kind of efforts. So every time only something done in the wartime will not be termed, or will not be only the exceptional thing, right? Even during some during peace time, you need to always put your efforts continuously. So service and campaign medals, which have been awarded throughout the history of the India as an independent state. So that's what you do have here, the gallantry awards, as well as some of the medals, for example, AVSM, PVSM, SM, right? So that kind of medals you can consider, right? In the earlier era, most of the awards or most of these gallantry awards are not being awarded, right? So you can look into these gallantry awards. Fine. So what you will be having in the gallantry awards? Fine. So altogether, now you will come to know 6 different gallantry awards, which are known as the facts at a glance, or the awards for the exceptional breweries. And these are nothing but the Paramvir Chakra, very first one, Ashok Chakra, Mahavir Chakra, Kirti Chakra, Veer Chakra, and Shaurya Chakra. Basically, all these are the gallantry awards. So, you cannot have the discrimination in between these awards. But as a matter of fact, you can put them hierarchically. So, highest one, and this is the very first one. And obviously, this is the highest one. Fine. So, any of the gallantry award would start from this one. That's called Shaurya Chakra. Right. Again, if you have done a kind of, or if you have exhibited a kind of exceptional bravery, right, then something else or something more to this, if you have exhibited, then you will be eligible for Veer Chakra. Further, if you have performed which is the eligibility of this chakra or greater than this chakra's eligibility, then you will be eligible for Kirti Chakra. And this is not a race or this is not a competition. This time I have won or awarded by Shaurya Chakra. Next time I will bring Veer Chakra or Kirti Chakra or I will go for Mahavir Chakra. Right? It's not a kind of competition kind of situation. Keep in mind. Right. Once in a lifetime of the entire career in the armed forces, that particular people, that particular person get a chance, right, to be to show his excellent bravery or extraordinary bravery. And for that, if it is undoubted, then he will be recommended. Still, though he is recommended, he will get, I'm not sure. Right. So likewise, you can consider hierarchically, this is the most one and this is the, you can say, the very first step, right, in the beginning of the gallantry awards. And this is the highest one called Paramvir Chakra, right, and the first one, Shaurya Chakra. So, Mahavir Chakra, Ashok Chakra, and Paramvir Chakra. So what these numbers are indicating? So these numbers indicate that till 26th of January 2021, these many awards, gallantry awards, have been given away or have been awarded. And all these awards are being awarded across the armed forces, not only for Indian Army or for Indian Navy or for Indian Air Force, altogether for all armed forces. Right. So for all armed forces. Now, you know, exceptional braveries, but these are the two exceptional braveries. Paramvir Chakra and Ashok Chakra. Only difference is that this is being shown on the field, whereas this is being shown in the peacekeeping or peacetime regions. The example is that in the earliest phase, I can tell you, Major Sandeep Unnikrishnan, he had been awarded with Ashok Chakra, who had lost his life, sacrificed, I would say, his life by showing exceptional bravery in the Operation Tornado carried out at the historical hotel of 5-star status, that is called Hotel Taj Mahal at Bombay during 2008 terrorist attack, right? Who had been the paramilitary commando, right? Or you can consider the NSG commando. Suppose instead of that Operation Tornado was being carried out instead of in the Hotel Taj Mahal at a front line or on the field, then I'm sure he would have been awarded Paramvir Chakra. So this is the difference between these two things you can keep in mind. So his bravery is exceptional, undoubted. Right? How it is undoubted? His colleague, right? His colleague of rank Havaldar, who had wounded, who had shot by 8 bullets by the terrorist. So still he was fighting. And on the very first roof or the first floor of Hotel Taj Mahal, they were racketing each and every room and rescuing the people trapped in these rooms and bringing these terrorists to a place or directly killing them so that they can terminate successfully or conclude successfully this particular operation called Tornado. But during this rescue operation, he is one of the colleagues got shot and severely wounded, right, because of 8 bullets hit his body. So he ordered him to go down to the base and have the first aid and get hospitalized. So that particular colleague was asking Major Sandeep Unnikrishnan not to go down and supporting him. So he said that, no, it's an order. Right. So obviously as a senior, he has to follow his order. And then he himself had gone for searching the terrorist. And in that particular search, he sacrificed his life. Right. So that's what you can consider. And obviously for on the field, if you show the same kind of exceptional bravery, right, by sacrificing your life, right, that doesn't mean only sacrificing your life would be eligibility for Paramvir Chakra. No. Out of 21 Paramvir Chakras, 7 are given away to alive people. Right, though the 14 are awarded posthumously. Right. So that's what you can consider. So 21 Paramvir Chakras till date have been awarded, 98 Ashok Chakras have been awarded, 222 Mahavir Chakras have been awarded till date, 494 Kirti Chakras have been awarded till date. Till date, 1339 Vir Chakras and 2150 Shaurya Chakras have been awarded. So altogether, if you consider these awards, then you can see how much small a number is this one as far as the strength is concerned, and it is over the period right from Independence Day and right from Independence Day. So that's what you can always keep in mind. Fine. Okay. So one by one, you can see the importance, what exactly these are, right? And then the awardees, I will just tell you about a little bit about each of the Paramvir Chakra awardee. Because of time limitation, it is not possible for all, and there is no point in telling all these the details of all these awardees for all other awards. At your own, you can no doubt see some of these. But again, some of the extraordinary among Veer Chakras and among Kirti Chakras will be told, right? But that would be very few. But as far as Paramvir Chakra awardees are concerned, all 21 we will be considering, because there are some really inspiring stories. And because of that, I will take you through these Paramvir Chakra awardees, right, or each of these Paramvir Chakra awardees. So let's go to the next one. So as far as Paramvir Chakra award is concerned, right, so no doubt here you will be coming across awardees, but prior to that you will have a kind of insignia, right, what kind of that particular chakra is. Fine. So here you do have a thing. I'm just asking you a question. No doubt here there is a national emblem. So what are these things? So this is, you have to find out at your own, what are these symbols? Okay. So details of this one, I will tell you that this is always, this is also made up of bronze, right? Bronze is very good, very pure bronze, right? But some other details you have to find out who had been designed this particular chakra, right? I will tell you, she is a lady, right, who had been designed this particular structure of this chakra. So Paramvir Chakra, very first one. It is nothing but India's highest military decoration, which is being awarded for the highest degree of valor or self-sacrifice. Valor, exceptional bravery, or self-sacrifice in presence of enemies. So that's what you can understand the difference between Ashok Chakra and PVC. So they are clearly equivalent to each other. Only thing is that one is at field, that is because of this particular compulsion in presence of enemy. And that to be on the field, and Ashok Chakra, that might be in presence of enemy, right? But in the compulsorily in the peacekeeping regions, right? Or in the civilian area, it can be awarded posthumously. Right? There are some of the awards which you can consider, right? So I will ask you one more question, though it is not directly related to this one, but I can ask. We do have India's highest civilian award called Bharat Ratna. Tanmay, will you make your mic mute, please? And please do these kinds of things in between. Right. Whenever you are unmuting yourself, you should unmute it only to talk. Okay, thank you. Yes, PVSM Padma, it is Padma or Param? Param Vishist Seva Medal, right? As like AVSM is Ati Vishist Seva Medal. Then VSM is like Vishist Seva Medal, right? SM is like Seva Medal, fine. So these are the short forms and abbreviations and their long forms you do have. Okay, so I was asking India's civilian, highest civilian award. So my question is that why that particular award is not conferred to father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi? So again, that is one more point in your homework, apart from designing of Paramvir Chakra, right? Why Gandhiji not conferred with the Bharat Ratna? Okay, so Paramvir Chakra was established on 26th of January 1950 by the President of India, having effect or with effect from 15th of August 1947. So statistics you do have established in 26th of January 1950. But on that day, it was decided that it would be awarded. Right. It would be awarded from independence. Right. It would be awarded from independence. So you will be seeing here that I'm saying established on 26th of January, awarded by decided to give away from the day of independence, and here the first awarded is written as 3rd November. Yes. So 3rd November 1947 comes later on 15th of August 1947. But on the 3rd November, first time, there had been something happened, right? Obviously, it was Major Somnath Sharma, right? So, which is nothing but, which found as the eligibility, right? Or which is nothing but the valor and self-sacrifice. So, it is verifying all the recommendations or all the points which are necessary to give away or to confer this particular award, right? And that was very first, it was happened on 3rd November 1947, right? No doubt it was posthumously. So though it was started from 15th August 1947, the first was on given away on the 3rd November 1947, fine. So last was awarded on 6th July 1990. Nine. So what was happened in this? So obviously it was Kargil War. Until date, as I said, 21 such awards have been awarded. Among them, 14 are posthumously awarded. Further, if you consider these 21, so among these 21 awardees, 20 are from Indian Army and only one from Indian Air Force. So 20 these recipients of PVC are of Indian Army and one is from Indian Navy. That to be again, since it is a statistic, that to be again, among these 20 recipients, most of these awards have been received by Sikh regiment. So Sikh regiment have received the most number of Paramvir Chakras. That to be. Among these 21, 14 have been awarded against the wars of Pakistan. See, consider this more this one more point, right, in this statistics. So among 21, 14 have been awarded against the wars of Pakistan. Fine. So what exactly this is? So that we have considered a little bit. Now, who were the awardees, rather who are awardees? Some of these awardees are still alive, right? Most of these awardees or those who have given their interviews, which are available on YouTube, you can go and see them or have a close look, try to hear them so that you will get benefited. By knowing these personalities, by knowing their valor and self-sacrifice or exceptional bravery is on field against different enemies in different situations. Fine. So, first is Major Somnath Sharma, Lance Naik Karam Singh, Second Lieutenant Ram Raghobar Rane, Nayak Jadunath Singh, CHM, that is Hawaldar Piru Singh, Captain Gurubachan Singh Salaria, Major Dhan Singh Thapa, Subedar Joginder Singh, Major Shaitan Singh, Hawaldar, it is Quartermaster Hawaldar, Abdul Hamid, Lieutenant Colonel Ardeshir Burzorji Tarafor, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrupal, Major Hoshiar Singh, Lance Naik, Albert Yakka, the Flying Officer, Nirmaljit Singh, Saikhan, Naib Subedar Bana Singh, Major Ramaswamy Parmeshwaran, Captain Vikram Batra, Lieutenant Manoj Kumar Pandey, Rifleman Sanjay Kumar, and the Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav. Fine. So these are the recipients of the Paramvir Chakra. So one by one, I will just take you through quickly through these awardees. So very first one is Somnath Sharma, Major Somnath Sharma. Right. So India's first Paramvir Chakra awardee, right, called Somnath Sharma. Now, if you consider this one, at this moment, I will tell you two more things related to Paramvir Chakra. The very first is about its equivalence, right? So equivalence in the globe, equivalence in other countries. So Paramvir Chakra, right, which is equivalent to Medal of Honor of United States of America. It is also equivalent to Victoria Cross of United Kingdom. So Medal of Honor of USA and Victoria Cross of UK are the two equivalent of PVC, right, of Paramvir Chakra. Fine. So this is one more point you can keep in mind. Sometimes the question might be asked about this one. Okay. Major Somnath Sharma, who born on 31st of January 1923 at Kangla district in Himachal Pradesh, whose father was Major General in Indian Army, and whose name was A.N. Sharma. So he retired as Major General. Major Somnath Sharma had been commissioned on 22nd of February 1942 in Kumaon Regiment. He had participated in Second World War, particularly in the operation of Arakon. He was the first Paramvir Chakra awardee. Further, his brother was also a military person, and he had held highest rank of Indian Army. So his brother, whose name was B.N. Sharma, had been General of Indian Army from 1988 to 90. See, the whole family had been the commissioned officers, had been served the country. Right. So father was Major General, brother was the general, right? He himself had been Major. Right. So at the time of his sacrifice, he was only of 25 years old. Right. So at the age of 25 years old, he was Major. Right. So if you could see, if God could have offered him more life, then probably we could have seen him at the highest position or the highest ranks as well. So what is his bravery? So what had happened? Vaibhav, shall I tell you to mute yourself? Yes, Ayush is giving the answer that Sir Bharat Ratna was established in 1953, given away in 1954. But Gandhiji had shot in 1948. Though it was decided to give posthumously, but when? With effect from that year itself. Right. So that was 93, and therefore the incident had been happened in 48, so it could not be awarded to Gandhi. And it is not only Gandhi, there are some other people, right, who could have got. But as far as Gandhi is concerned, right, it was exceptional. Right? Even you can consider his contribution. Right? So that's what you can consider. No doubt, the list is continually going on. And obviously, Mr. Tendulkar had joined that particular list. So I was talking about See, on 22nd of October 1947, there had been some attacks by Pakistani soldiers in J&K. Right? Okay, I will tell this story tomorrow. It will take at least 3-4 minutes, so that it will be completely justifying the bravery of Major Somnath Sharma. Right? Okay, we are running out of time, so I will stop here. Anything which you would like to ask?
No, sir.
Okay, if nothing is there, then we will stop here and we will complete this one. Can we have extra session tomorrow of around two hours? I'm asking to the students, so that in that particular phase, we might be finishing out this topic in a single stroke. If you are ready, you can.
Yes, sir.
You can convince yes, to Rishikesh, sir. And if it is convenient for him, he will let me know about it. Right. Anyway, I will stop here. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day, sir.
Wait, dear student, don't go anywhere. Math lecture will continue soon.